Hello everyone. Today we are going to derive the equation for hydraulic jump. Okay. Basically, last time we have seen what is the meaning of hydraulic jump, what is the concept of hydraulic jump, and what are the applications of hydraulic jump. Okay. So today we are going to derive the equation for the same. Alright. So we have seen last time that when we have a supercritical flow, that is incoming supercritical flow. Suppose. Okay. Some flow is taking place in a supercritical regime. So now here, this is Y1 in the supercritical regime. Okay. And it encounters, why it is supercritical? Suppose if you see that the critical depth line is this one. Okay. So this is your YC. Okay. This is your critical depth line. So incoming flow depth is less than the critical depth. So incoming flow is a supercritical flow. Proud number is greater than 1. It encounters a subcritical flow, suppose in the downstream, where depth is greater than the critical depth. Then there is a sudden change in supercritical flow depth from supercritical to subcritical. Okay. This sudden change in the flow depth is called as the hydraulic jump. It is accompanied by a lot of turbulence, formation of rollers, and energy dissipation. So we have discussed these things last time, and today we want to develop an equation for the depths of hydraulic jump. Basically, these are the two depths, Y1 and suppose this is Y2. Okay. These are the two depths, Y1 and Y2. Y1 is the depth before hydraulic jump, Y2 is the depth after hydraulic jump. And we want to derive the equation for this depths basically. Okay. So today we are going to do just that. We have already discussed that these depths are basically called as the sequent depths or conjugate depths. And what is the similarity between at both these locations, 1 and 2? Basically, what is the similarity? Similarity is that the specific force at both the locations is same. Okay. Specific energy is different, but specific forces are same. We will discuss that later. First, we will try to derive the equation for Y1 and Y2. Okay. So, we will apply the momentum equation for the same. That is, we will apply Newton's second law of motion to get the relationship between Y1 and Y2. For that, first we have to find out what are the forces acting on this control volume. I have drawn a control volume here. The control volume will encompass the hydraulic jump. So, what are the forces acting on this control volume? First force I have already drawn, that is the weight of the fluid inside the control volume. Okay. So, sine component of the weight is acting in the flow direction. Okay. So, this is one force acting on the control volume. It is a body force acting in the flow direction, W sine theta. What can be another force? Okay. Now, this channel bed is in contact with the fluid. Okay. So, it will apply some resistance to the flow. So, that will give rise to a resistance force because of the shear stress between the boundary and the fluid. Okay, so that force I will write by, I will call it as FF. Okay, this is the resistance force FF. Okay, so force causing the motion is W sine theta, resisting force is FF suppose. Now, pressure forces will also act. Now, since we are trying to find the forces on control volume, so we have separated the control volume from the fluid. So we will also have to encompass the effect of hydrostatic pressure, which is in contact with the control surface. Now here, this is this surface is in contact with the fluid. So a hydrostatic force will be acting like this. Okay. Similarly, so some pressure P1 force will be acting here. Some pressure P1. Okay. Similarly, pressure force P2 will be acting on this side. Okay. So this might be P2. So P1 and P2, they will act normal to the surface. Okay. So P1 is the pressure force on surface 1 or section 1. P2 is the pressure force on section 2. Okay. Both pressure forces, actually pressure force will act always 90 degrees to the surface. surface in consideration.
Okay.
All right. So with these forces in mind, we will try to apply the Newton's second law of motion on this control volume. All right.
So applying Newton's second law, what we get?
What does it say? The summation of forces acting on this control volume, summation of forces in the direction of the flow.
In flow direction, I should say. In flow direction.
Summation of forces is equal to the rate of change of momentum
in that direction. Okay. Rate of change of momentum in flow direction.
Okay. So now summation of forces, we should write on the left hand side. What are the forces? All the forces. So we have P1 in the flow direction, P2 opposite to the flow direction. So we can write
P1 minus P2.
Again, the force causing the motion is W sin theta. It is acting in the direction of the motion. FF is the resistance force opposite to the direction of the flow. So
plus W sin theta minus FF. These are all the forces.
That should be equal to
rate of change of, so time rate of change of momentum.
Okay, so momentum is what?
Mass into velocity, MV.
Okay. So this, you can also write, now mass you can take outside, so M by T, you can write ddt of, so you can write V2 minus V1, okay? Because mass you can take outside of the differential, mass is constant suppose. So V2 minus V1 will give you rate of change of basically velocity and multiplied by this M, okay? So this becomes time rate of change of momentum, M by T into V2 minus V1. But what is this M by T? M by T is
mass flux or mass flow rate.
Okay, mass flowing per unit time. Okay, so we can write
P1 minus P2 plus W sin theta minus FF is equal to,
M by T is mass flow rate. So how to write the mass flow rate? We can write volume flow rate into density. So rho is the mass density multiplied by Q. Q is the volume flow rate. So meter cube per second multiplied by kilogram per meter cube. We are going to get kilogram per second, that is how much mass is flowing per unit time
into V2 minus V1.
Okay. Now see, now for hydraulic jumps, if we consider that this bed slope is very small, suppose theta is very small, then sin theta will become 0. Okay. So
for small angles, small bed slope, small theta, sin theta will become almost equal to 0.
So we can neglect this W sin theta also. And we have already seen that in the hydraulic jump, the change of depth occurs in a very short length of channel. Okay, this is the length of channel, suppose L. Okay, the L is very small. Okay, L is not very large in kilometers. L is quite small in meters itself. Okay, so we can neglect the resistance force also, because the shear resistance is only applicable on this length in consideration. Okay, so shear area will again decrease, so we can neglect this resistance force also. So we are finally getting the expression as P1 minus P2 equal to rho Q V2 minus V1. Okay. So this is our momentum equation. We have to, now we will use this momentum equation further to get the expression for Y1 and Y2. Okay. Now, in order to go ahead, we have to decide, basically we have to decide what kind of channel it is. You can derive for rectangular channel, trapezoidal, etc. So right now we will derive for simply for a rectangular channel. So suppose this channel is a rectangular channel.
Okay. Suppose this is a rectangular channel. B is the base width. Okay.
And Y will be the depth. So here the depth will be Y1, here the depth will be Y2. Channel width is B. Okay. Now, so therefore you can write Now we can also find out P1 and P2. What are P1 and P2? P1 is the total pressure force. Okay, so what is the total pressure force basically? Total pressure force is the pressure force basically, the pressure force acting on this surface 1. Okay, so how to find that? So pressure force is equal to, we know the general formulation for pressure force is rho g A into z bar. Okay, so suppose there is a vertical surface like this. Okay, so this is a vertical surface, suppose this is the depth, suppose y. Okay, and this is a rectangle channel, suppose. Okay, and the flow depth is suppose y. So on this channel or on this surface, if you want to find out the pressure force, the pressure distribution will be triangular like this, 0 at the top, and it will go on increasing. At the bottom, pressure intensity will be rho into g into y, rho g y. Okay, and what will be the total pressure force now? P, pressure force is equal to rho into g into A is the area on which the pressure is acting. So area here is b into y is the area. Okay, so this is your flow area A, and what is the z bar is the depth of centroid from the water surface. So what is the depth of centroid now for this rectangle? The centroid is at y/2 from the top. Okay, y/2 from the top. So z bar is equal to y/2. So just for rectangular channel, we get the expression P equal to rho g. Now suppose this is a1, this depth is suppose y1, so it will be y1 into b, and z1 bar will be rho g y1 b. z1 is y1/2. Okay, y1/2. So our pressure force comes rho or half rho g y1 square into b. Okay, this is the total pressure force acting on the surface y1. Okay, similarly your p2 will become half rho g y2 square into b. Okay, by the same analogy you can find out the total pressure. Okay, so we can write the expression as this. I can erase this. We have seen earlier also, this you know already, what is the pressure force and total pressure force, how to calculate and write it. Okay, so I will replace it by p1 as half rho g y1 square into b, minus p2 will be half rho g y2 square into b. Okay, that will be equal to rho into, now q, how you can write volume flow rate, area into velocity. So a1 into v1. Okay, and again v2 minus v1. So you can write half rho g b, you can take half rho g b common, you can write y1 square minus y2 square is equal to rho a1 is y1 into b, v1 v2 minus v1. Okay, so here your rho gets cancelled and your base width also gets cancelled, so our expression is half g y1 square minus y2 square is equal to y1 into v1 v2 minus v1. Okay, all right. Now y1 square minus y2 square you can write as y1 plus y2, y1 minus y2. Okay, so you have to write y1 minus y2, y1 plus y2 is equal to, take the 2 here, so 2y1 v1 into v2 minus v1 upon g. Okay, all right. Now So this is our expression. Now we will write here we have V1, but here we have one V2. So we will replace V2 in some other form.
Okay. So let's replace
V2 by some other form.
We know that by continuity equation, we know that A1V1 equal to A2V2. Okay, this we know by continuity equation.
Discharge at this location is same as discharge at this location. Okay.
Mass conservation principle. So we have seen that also. So A1 you can write Y1 into B, V1 is equal to A2 you can write Y2 into B, V2. Okay.
So what you are left with? Y1, V1 equal to Y2, V2.
So use this expression to write V2. V2 you can write Y1 by Y2 into V1. Okay. So you can use this expression
and replace this here. So our expression is
Y1 minus Y2, Y1 plus Y2 is equal to,
now twice,
Y1 V1 upon G, V2 minus V1. So V2, I will write this, Y1 by Y2 into V1 minus V1.
Okay, like this. Okay, Y1 by Y2 V1 minus V1.
So now we have Y1 minus Y2, Y1 plus Y2 is equal to, now take the V1 outside, so twice Y1 V1 square by G, we are getting Y1 by Y2 minus 1. Okay,
so you can write, just cross multiply, it will be Y1 minus Y2 upon Y2. So just for the next step, I will write the next step here itself. You can write Y1 minus Y2 upon Y2. Okay. So now this Y1 minus Y2 will get cancelled from both the sides. So you are left with Y1 plus Y2 is equal to 2Y1 V1 square upon GY2.
Okay.
Alright, so we are left with this. Now moving ahead, I am taking Y2 by Y1 on one side, so we have Y2 by Y1 into Y1 plus Y2 Okay, so
before going to this step, we'll just if we look at this V1 square by G, then we know that what is the expression for Froude number. Froude number is V upon under root GY1 or GY. So FR1 square will be, how we can write square of Froude number at 1, we can write V1 square by GY1. Okay, so if we look at here, what expressions, basically I want to bring Froude number in this equation. So you see what is missing here, V1 square by GY1. So below this, in this denominator I need Y1. So multiply and divide by Y1. So I am getting Y1 upon Y1. Okay, so it will not affect the expression, but V1 square by G into Y1 will be FR1 square. Okay, so just replace that. So Y1 plus Y2 is equal to 2Y1 square upon Y2 into FR1 square.
Okay, so now I will take Y2 by Y1 on one side, so we have Y2 by Y1 square, Y1 plus Y2. Okay, Y2 here and Y1 square at the denominator, and what is left on the right hand side, twice FR1 square. So now here bring the Y1 inside this bracket, so we have y2 by y1, it will be 1 plus, because y1 upon y1 will be 1, again 1 plus y2 by y1 equal to 2 fr1 square. Okay, so now if we multiply, what we are getting, y2 by y1, I am writing this term first, so it will be square, y2 by y1 square plus 2 by y1 minus twice fr1 square equal to 0. Okay, so basically what is it? It is a quadratic equation. And how we can visualize this equation? Ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Okay, the equation is of this form. If you look at this equation, ax square plus bx plus c. Okay, so what are the constants here? A is, okay, what is x basically? X is y2 by y1. Okay, this is x. Okay, and what are the coefficients? A, B and C. So here A is 1 and B is also 1, and what is C? Minus 2 FR1 square. Okay, so we have a direct solution for this type of quadratic equation. What is that? So x equal to minus b plus minus under root of b square minus 4ac upon 2a. Okay, so this is the direct solution of this such type of quadratic equation. Okay, so we will just put the values of a, b, c and get the values of y2 by y1. Okay, so just now x is what? X is y2 by y1. So our solution is y2 by y1 is equal to minus b. B is 1. So b minus 1 plus minus under root of b square. Okay. So b square is 1. Okay. B is 1. So b square will be 1. Minus 4 into a is 1 into c is minus 2 FR1 square. Okay, upon 2 into A is 1. Okay, so we are getting Y2 by Y1 is equal to minus 1 plus minus under root of 1 plus minus minus will become plus, so 1 plus 8 FR1 whole square. Okay, upon 2. Now if I consider the minus sign, the depth will come negative, so that is not physically possible. So only one solution will be a visible solution, that will be y2 by y1 equal to minus 1 plus under root of 1 plus 8 fr1 whole square by 2. So we will convert it into the form which is more famous, that is half. You take, if you take half common, we are getting root of 1 plus 8 FR1 square minus 1. Okay, so this is the equation for depths of hydraulic jump Y2 and Y1. Okay, so whenever we need to calculate the depths, so some problem is given and you need to calculate the depth of hydraulic jump, something related to depths, then or suppose Froude number, then we can use this equation. Okay, to calculate the depths of hydraulic jump. Basically these two depths are the secant depths or conjugate depths. Okay, and you can use this formula to calculate y1 and y2. Okay, thank you.